Hi everyone. So, I'm going to continue with our look at the HTC One M8 by taking you through the security features and showing you how to set those up. Obviously, security on any smartphone is really important, and no more so here. So, what we need to do first is come into our security area of the settings. So, if you come into settings, come down to security. And in there, we have the screen lock and kid mode. And those are the kind of two primary toggles, as it were, we're interested in. The screen lock, very much for your personal security, but the kid mode there, so that you can make sure that your children, family members, can only access certain apps on your device. First, let's set up the screen lock. So to do that, we come into the screen lock, and we've kind of got four options there, really. Face unlock, pattern, PIN, and password. Now the face unlock works reasonably well in a reasonable number of scenarios, or however, it does require good lighting. So we go into setup and we just work our way through this, and what it will then do is it wants to pop me in the center of this circle, and it's checking my face at this point. There we go. And now you can train this a few different times if you need to after you've set it up to kind of improve things. And what we'll do then is we'll add a pin lock, pattern pin even. Now the idea behind that is if for any reason the camera can't detect your face, what it will do is it will give you an option to use your pattern pin, as it were. So now all we need to do is swipe up and it's going to check my face, and you can see how quick it is. As soon as it sees your face there and it matches up, it will let you straight in. There's no real delay there. Now there are some other options you can turn on with the face unlock. We come back into settings, into security. Now can you see here, liveness check, this option here, just underneath improve face matching. This area here has just changed slightly to give us some more options. If we turn on liveness check, it will require an eye blink when it's unlocking. Now, in our testing, we found this to be really unreliable. Most of the time, it simply doesn't even detect that you're blinking. If you're wearing glasses, forget it, it just doesn't work at all. So just be aware that if you happen to turn that on, it isn't the most reliable thing in the world. So, next options we have there is improving your face matching. So you can run this a few times under different lighting conditions to help improve the face match. Make the pattern visible. So if you don't want the pattern to be seen on screen, if you're concerned about someone looking over your shoulder, you can turn that on or off in this case. You've got your enabling your lock screen widgets as well. Now, if we come back into screen lock and we just sign that in, our other options is to set up a pattern, which is what we've just seen already. We can record a pattern on the screen, which we then have to do again when we want to log in. If we come back into here again, we can also set up a PIN number, which can be a number of digits. So in this case, 6. And also we can use a password as well. And you can see that when I want to come in and actually change any of these options, it's asking me to re-enter the last setup password system, as it were. So there it's asking me for the PIN before I could come in and actually change those. And likewise, I can put in a password. All of these work pretty well, and they are obviously necessary if you want to use any of the security features for encrypting on the device. You will be asked to set these up. Now, other options you can have is really how the lock screen is going to operate when it's in a secure mode. So unlocking music automatically, unlocking for incoming calls, make your passwords visible if you need that help, and also setting up some device administration options, including encrypting all of your details. Now, the next option that we have in here, which is very useful for a lot of people, certainly for people with families, is kid mode. This has become very, very popular. Now, what kid mode allows you to do is to set the device into kind of a cut-down interface, which only provides access to child-friendly and child-safe apps. And you can make sure that only you can control which apps are going to be accessible, or you can have a bit more flexibility there. Now, to actually do that, once we've kind of set it up, we initially come into here, we set up our parents' dashboard in here, which creates our various profiles. And you can see here, the actual app is provided by a company called Zoodles Kid Mode. Now to activate Kid Mode, all we need to do is come into our app tray, find Kid Mode and click. Now you have to run through an initial setup process, which effectively means making Kid Mode kind of the default so that a young person can't back out of it, thus getting back to all of your apps. And then once you actually have it set up, it will ask you to register an email address, and then you get access to this system. And in here, we have the ability really to provide some tools and entertainment for young people, including video footage, the games that we might have on here that we want to allow them to play, drawing applications, and even interactive storybooks, which I thought was a really nice little touch on the part of HTC to, you know, include an app which actually has this kind of functionality in there as well. Really, really nice. You also have the ability to turn on video mail as well for your child, and various different things that kind of keep your child entertained but keep them away from any of your more sensitive stuff on your device or the internet in general. To actually come back out of that, to actually exit, your child will have to type in, or you will have to type in, your year of birth. Now obviously you could use a different PIN there if you wanted to. So those are the main security features of the HTC One. There's not a huge amount of kind of new stuff here, as it were. It's all very much standard stuff we've seen in Android before, but obviously the addition of the kid mode there, which I think is really, really useful. For watching, we hope you enjoyed this video. Do please remember to like and comment, and if you'd like to, please subscribe. You can also visit our website and download our Android app. If you do subscribe, you'll be getting a daily dose of the latest tech news, hardware reviews, Android games, consoles, and basically an honest opinion direct from the UK. Stay tuned, stay Androidizen.